Wednesday 25/2/15. This cat has been treated for FLUTD or feline lower urinary tract disease by another vet about 15 days ago, and he went home, but he wasn't eating and was dehydrated and lame. Then after 10 days he came here for treatment, so I had an x-ray done as well as a urine test and antibiotic sensitivity test, and the urine test shows that there's a bacteria which is resistant to the Clavulox, which the vet prescribed. Normally this is commonly prescribed for cats and dogs, and so the cat was still having blood in the urine, and surprisingly the x-ray showed the kidneys were swollen 3 to 6 times. This is shown in another video earlier on. And after 2 days of treatment drips, the cat went home, but the cat didn't want to eat. So the owner hand fed the cat with canned food. But as you can see, the cat developed ulcers. There was a big ulcer on the gum here yesterday, probably due to friction from force feeding, and you can see the ulcer here. Yesterday there was a big commissure ulcer, abscess. So the cat was badly dehydrated and recumbent yesterday, wasn't able to even sit up now. Okay, now the cat can sit up after being given 250 ml of fluids plus amino acids plus antibiotics, and of course he's stronger. Now the temperature, yesterday he came in when he was recumbent. This is a male, not neutered cat, 1.5 years old. Temperature yesterday was very low. So it was 35.1. And the cat is really thin, weighing about 3.4 kg. Today, he's sitting on his sternum. He looks better. Temperature is 36.8, which is slightly better than 35.1 yesterday. And certainly he looks much better, but you can see the discharge on the eye, the left eye. There's an eye discharge. And he has no more blood in the urine. We did the FIV and FELV test, the leukemia test and the FIV test, and it was negative. So there's one good news. Now the kidneys are no more swollen. Kidneys are no more swollen from palpation. It's back to the normal size. And of course there's no pain now because of the, although there's some pain still. The vet had taken a blood test. There was on admission with FLUTD, and the blood test showed septicemia, including high creatinine values. So the kidney was actually infected due to the bladder obstruction before treatment by the vet. So the chances of this cat surviving is quite slim. Because once you have septicemia with bladder obstruction, that is even worse than just bladder obstruction alone. So that's why it takes a long time to recover. The problem is the cat doesn't want to eat, and so force feeding causes ulcers in the right side of the mouth. So you see the left side, there is no ulcer. We turn over and we see the left side. Left side, open the mouth, you see that there's no ulcer on the gums. No ulcer, but it's still anemic, you can see. This cat is still anemic. Now we open the mouth, you see the tongue. The tongue, there's a big ulcer there, according to the owner. And to open the tongue, sit the cat properly in a proper position, grip the top part, and then open the tongue with like this. You can see the ulcer there. Now this ulcer this ulcer in the center of the tongue will be the cause of why the cat doesn't want to eat. Now this ulcer could be due to, we could call it the uremic ulcer, because this cat had very high creatinine levels about 14 days ago at the first consultation. And so you could explain why the cat doesn't want to eat. Now if you can see the ulcer, it's quite a big one, and that explains why the cat doesn't want to eat on his own. Now this also could be due to force feeding by the owner too. Now the problem with this the prescription diet KD is that it contains pork. KD, science diet KD, can plus dry food contains pork, so you can't give to this cat for religious reasons. And the Royal Canine, the canned kidney diet, also contains pork. So the only food for kidney diseases in cat will be the Royal Canine dry food. Now, it's already hard to feed canned food, so feeding dry food will be harder, as the cat has ulcers in the mouth. So today now, we are giving drips the last 2 days. And we'll wait and see. The kidney is no longer swollen from palpation, but there's still some pain. March 25, 2015, Toa Payoh Vets.